ัสดีค่ะ and welcome back to At Bright Insight with me กรกนกวิชิตพันธ์ serving you the most leading Buddhist news from across the globe. Start with the 2019 Global Buddhist Ambassador Award. Honorary President of the World Alliance of Buddhists, พระเดชพระคุณพระเทพรัตนสุทธี the Pathum Thani Governor, presented the 2019 Global Buddhist Ambassador Awards to 24 Buddhist monks and ambassadors on the occasion of Vesak Day. The Global Buddhist Ambassador Awards first started in the year 2017 to reward the Buddhist monks and ambassadors whose devotion and dedication to prosperity of Buddhism and creating world peace and harmony throughout the world. The award recipients were from 8 countries including Cambodia, Myanmar, India, Nepal, Sri Lanka, Taiwan, Singapore, and Thailand. Congratulations to all award recipients. Moving on to our next news, 24 branches of Wapatamagaya in Europe organized the European Ordination Program. More and more Westerners are interested in the study of Buddhism. Thus, men from many countries in Europe, such as Germany, England, Czech Republic, France, Sweden, Belgium, and Netherlands, entered the European Ordination Program to practice and follow the way the Lord Buddha has discovered the truth of life. The ordination ceremony took place at Wapatamagaya Benelux in Belgium, joined by the participants' families. It was conducted accordingly to the Buddhist tradition. All dressed in white, the soon-to-be monks first need to seek for forgiveness from their parents or guardians as a way to purify their minds. After that, their family's members will shave their heads and eyebrows and offer them a set of 7 robes and alms bowls. Lastly, the soon-to-be monks would ask permission for the ordination from their preceptor before they officially turn into the Buddhist monks. They must know the basic knowledge of Tripajam, the 5 unattractive parts of the body, and the ways to observe the precepts. Buddhist monks are the keys to the prosperity of Buddhism. Rejoice in all your merit. Next, monks and devotees of Wapatamagaya Toshinyi held a ceremony to enshrine the great master Pratmongkon Temuni statue. Monks and Japanese devotees held a ceremony to enshrine the great master Pratmongkon Temuni statue took place at the Magaya International Center Toshinyi. The ceremony started with a statue procession around the temple. Pictures show the monks and devotees were escorting Pratmongkon Temuni statue before they entered the ceremonial center. Enshrining the great master's statue was a way to pay utmost reverence to his exemplary virtues. He is the later Abbot of Wat Pak Nam and the rediscoverer of Visuddhimagga, a meditation method believed to have been used by the Lord Buddha himself to gain enlightenment. The great master statue would inspire the new generations to do good deeds and to practice meditation, making this world full of peace. Next, a British teacher introduced meditation to her students to improve their performance in the classroom. A teacher from Holbridge School was inspired by meditation that she learned from the Magaya London. After that, she began to introduce meditation to her students to help curb their anxiety and improve their performance in the classroom. She held a collaborated meditation class with a teaching monk from the Magaya London, a well-known Thai temple in England. As the meditation session began, the kids followed the teaching monk's instruction. They closed their eyes and sat with their legs crisscrossed. Finally, the guided meditation ended with a Q&A session. And it's not just the kids. More adults are practicing meditation too. Let us move to our last news this week. The executive director of MMI gave his insight on the spiritual tourism event. Venerable Burin Thitakusaro, executive director of MMI, was invited to be the speaker of the spiritual tourism event at Kathmandu on June 7, 2019. The event witnessed participation of over 700 delegates from 43 different countries. Over 40 international travel bloggers and media representatives, as well as over 100 local media delegates, participated in the famous event. Venerable Burin Thitak Kusaro shared his insight with the topic of Buddha's teachings, sublime attractions to the spiritual tourism in the Himalayas. He emphasized the attractiveness of the Lord Buddha's teachings, which are universality, self-evidence, and timelessness. He encouraged all business and government leaders to practice meditation and learn wisdom by themselves in order to understand how spirituality can benefit their lives and can bring greater value to tourism business. These are all top 5 leading news for you this week. It's time for us to move on to our special scoop. Monks and devotees from different sects of Buddhism joined the 2019 Visakh Day event at the Magaya International Meditation Center of California.
Celebrate Visakha Puja Day, the day the Buddha was born, enlightenment and parinirvan or passing away. Here in Azusa, the Dhammakaya International Meditation Center, we have celebration every year, and among all the nations, all races come and gather to celebrate, meditate and light the candle.
The Buddha's teachings always embrace us as a loving kindness and compassion and wisdom. So we really hope that everyone will practice all the Buddhist way to complete their way of living as a Buddhist. Actually, this is our first time to coming here, but I was invited to the different Buddhist organizations for the Vesak festival. I think this is the biggest. So I feel that all the people's energy and passion to support the Buddhist teachings. So I really appreciate everyone's help and support to complete today's Vesak days.
I'm very honored to have come to this beautiful night on Buddha's birthday. I really enjoyed the unity of everybody, the meditation, and just the beautiful chanting that I've heard. And I look forward to attending the same ceremony next year.
The energy of tonight and the candle lighting and just the peace that was shared is the peace that needs to be spread out throughout the whole world. Meditation and contemplative practice changes us from the inside out. We think that we need to change the outside world to change us on the inside, and it's actually the opposite. We need to change ourselves on the inside, and that's what meditation does.
Thank you. I'm glad to be celebrating this wonderful day. I love the chanting, the candles, the sense of unity, and the peace that is surrounding this whole area. And it's been just an honor to be here.
I really enjoy the whole ceremony. I love the way they teach meditation here. I love the culture that I get here. And it's just a wonderful place to be on such a beautiful night.
I've been here four or five times. It's a very meaningful event. It's a peaceful candlelight section, and then meditation is very well. We really enjoy it.
We also light the candles. We want to spread the love and kindness to everyone here, and everyone is so happy to be here. And we lit the candle. It's amazing. It's so beautiful at the temple. So I want to say that I'm really happy, and I want to continue to come to the main event and to see this amazing event again and to see amazing people.
Chinese culture, the Fudan people, may have a little bit of a difference between Thailand and the Wei Sai Jie. In Chinese culture, 像西来寺、西来堂跑也有办过福诞节，福诞节是四月初八，应该是佛陀的出生日嘛，这是应该庆祝、值得庆祝的。在今天的外面的这个 light 这个点灯啊，非常非常来说的话，象征一种灯灯相传吧，把佛法延续下去。I
really like the idea of the world peace through inner peace, the loving kindness and peace spreading meditation, and that's why I've been coming and continuing to come here.
I believe that if the Buddha is still alive, he will be blessed and happy with son and daughters, all the monks, disciples here that we gather tonight with the bright and clear mind to celebrate the Buddha Visakha Pooja. So on behalf of the Mahayana International Meditation Center, we thank you everyone, our venerable monks, neighbors, friends, who come and meditate and share the positive energy to create peace from within and share to the people out to the world. Thank you for joining us here and share the positive energy. So share the merit to everyone.
Visak Day is a day where we can all commemorate the Lord Buddha's birth, enlightenment, and attaining Nirvana. Rejoice in all your merit. Let us end it by insight with the Lord Buddha's Dhamma quote. The secret of health for both mind and body is not to mourn for the past, nor to worry about the future, but to live the present moment wisely and earnestly. It's time for us to say goodbye, but don't forget to watch all episodes of At Bright Insight program by visiting our Global Buddhist Network official website, gbnus.com, or from the Facebook page, gbnus. Thank you for joining us, and see you again next week. สวัสดีค่ะ.